Caskets are often associated with vampires in movies and literature. In these tales, a vampire roams at night, but must return to their casket before sunrise. Caskets are usually made of either wood or metal, and range in style from understated to ornate. There are two styles of caskets. Full couch models have an undivided top to show the deceased from head to toe. Perfection cut models have a split top to show the deceased only from the waist up. This factory makes metal caskets constructed from sheets of steel. To form the top, workers insert a sheet into a press. A die inside draws the metal into a paneled shape. This requires 900 tons of pulling force, the equivalent of hoisting 27 fully loaded tractor trailers. After trimming the edges, workers insert the panel into an automated folding machine. First, the machine bends both long sides upward, two bends of 90 degrees each. Second, it bends both short sides upward the same way. Then workers weld the corner seams. They also assemble and weld the casket's side, end, and reinforced bottom panels. These too were shaped in the press, but with a different type of die which stamps rather than draws the steel to the required shape. For a perfection cut casket, they saw the top in half, then weld steel to the cut end, forming a header to give it a neatly finished look. An automated belt grinds all the welds flat to create a smooth finish. After a cleaning, all the parts travel through a booth, inside which 20 automated spray guns coat them in powder paint. An electrical charge draws the powder particles onto the steel, ensuring a thorough and even coat, which a giant oven then bakes for 20 minutes. Once the surface cools, workers inspect the paint finish to make sure it's flawless. Workers apply hot melt glue on the inside, along where the bottom and sides meet. This makes the body of the casket watertight, and they conduct a water test to make sure. The casket is lined with crepe, a synthetic fabric which is formable when you apply high heat. This specially designed machine heats the material with an iron, as serrated wheels gather into decorative pleats known as shirring. The high heat forms the fabric to this shape permanently. Sewers cut and sew the shirred fabric into lining components. Meanwhile, workers mount the casket's steel hardware, either stationary handles or swing bar handles which pivot. They place a rubber gasket around the top edge to ensure a proper seal when the top is closed. Then they mount the top. The gasket has holes for the steel hinges. By this point, they've already attached most of the interior fabric over an inner lining of corrugated cardboard. Now it's time to install the steel bed using an expandable rod. The bed's height is adjustable, enabling funeral directors to elevate the deceased for easier viewing. A mattress pad and sheet go on the top of the bed. Clips on each end hold them in place. A pillow completes the interior. Every casket undergoes a thorough final inspection. Then it's shipped to the funeral home that ordered it. The funeral home typically displays several sample pieces showing the range of styles, colors, hardware, and fabric options available for a loved one's casket.